La بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله سيد الأنبياء وخاتم المرسلين أدى الأمانة وبلغ الرسالة ونصح الأمة وكشف بها الغمة وجاهد في الله حق جهاده. Brothers and sisters in Islam, respected viewers, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, and ahlan wa sahlan, welcome to our program. Let me make a special dua, first of all, to Almighty Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. May Allah tabarak wa ta'ala grant shifa to those who are sick, especially those who got cancer or those who are on medication of chemotherapy. May Allah tabarak wa ta'ala make it easy for them, and may Allah entertain them and take that pain away from them. Allahumma shfihim wa afihim ya Rabbil Alameen. And let me make a special dua for those who are suffering from any disease. May Allah tabarak wa ta'ala be with them. May Allah reward you. May Allah tabarak wa ta'ala elevate your status in the day of Qiyamah with the Anbiya and Siddiqeen and Shuhada. Brothers and sisters in Islam, we got a request from many of our brothers, those who are terribly sick. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept your dua for them, inshallah. Please make dua for those who are sick in the hospital, especially those who are suffering from a dead disease or that cancer. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us and grant them shifa, ajilan ghayra ajil. May Allah grant them miracle. May Allah tabarak wa ta'ala save them and lift that pain from them, inshallah. Brothers and sisters in Islam, once again we welcome you to our program and shukran jazeeran. And once again I'm thanking Allah tabarak wa ta'ala that I receive a dua from our elderly people. I'm very, very happy and fortunate. I'm really, really grateful to Allah that that old lady, I don't believe that they are old, but you know, I receive some calls and message and people meet us and say, my grandmother greet you and give salam and all this. I'm very, very happy because we are here on TV for you. Make a special dua. May Allah tabarak wa ta'ala grant you health and sahat and afiyah. May Allah reward you for all what you have done to your children, for your children, or for the society and for your grandchildren. May Allah reward you. I know so many of our elderly women and men, they did not get the proper payment in dunya. But inshallah, indallah, it will be there. And I think you are most fortunate person when you receive all your payment in your grave and akhirah. Because whatever payment you use it here is going to get an end. But you're lucky and you just invest with Allah and say, Ya Allah, I want it in the day of Qiyamah. When you close your eyes, you will see a big surprise when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant you بِغَيْرِ حِسَابِ إِنَّمَا يُوَفَّى الصَّابِرُونَ أَجْرَهُمْ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابِ. Indeed, the people of Sabr, I don't want to talk about this old age people today, it's not my topic, but let me repeat again, we are living because of the barakah of these people. I'm very, very proud of the effort of our widow, that lady was suffering on that olden days to bring up the salih children. They gave the society doctors, professional, engineer, business people, and Allah tabarak wa ta'ala grant them a good harvest and good fruit and production. And I promise you, you will see, inshallah, and definitely you will meet, inshallah, in akhirah, and you will remember that to have that effort in your life, it will never go astray. فَلَا إِنْشَاءَ فَلَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. Brothers and sisters in Islam, my friend, he was watching the program, and then he said, I want to know that something is called Nahi. I was talking about something Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam authorized it as haram. We know our Sharia comes in Quran, they call it Sharia law, and Sunnah. Sunnah is the Hadith. So many of our young boys and girls, they say, I trust Quran. But we know that مَا أَتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُذُوهُ. Whatever Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم give you, you must take it. وَمَا نَهَاكُمْ عَنْهُ فَانْتَهُ. Whatever he prohibited you, you must stay away from it. Because if you doubt about the hadith, Nabi Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم is the same one who give you Quran. So you still have one card. It's called the Quran. We don't disregard the hadith of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, and we accept. And whatever, trust me, whatever we use here, it's a correct, authentic hadith, because before we say it to you, we think about our akhirah. You know, when you are on TV or in a masjid, or you give bayan, or you try to preach, before we answer and we utter, we're scared of our account on the day of Qiyamah. So it's not easy to come on TV and you just say something and you tell people like that. Is not. You must get a reference, authentic thing, especially of haram and halal, because you confuse the people and you irritate the life of the people. If it's haram, we have to say it haram. If it's halal, we can't hide, because al haram ubayyin wal halal ubayyin. Now I'm continuing now with that prohibition, what Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam forbid. When we say forbid, you say do not do it, you will be punished for it. Now you look for it in Quran, you don't find it, but you find it in the hadith. So that is called wa ati'u Allah wa ati'u Rasul. Obey Allah and obey the Rasul. Wa ma yantiqu 'anil hawa. Our Nabi does not talk from his own. Now you say, is it correct hadith? Is not is a weak hadith and all that? You must study the terminology of hadith. You must know what is all the type of a hadith, because some people just break the hadith to hadith correct, hadith sahih, and hadith da'if. But they don't talk about the hadith was marfu', you got so mutawatir, ahad, you got plenty of hadith. So you must know that a hadith got categories, right? Weak hadith, it doesn't mean it's incorrect. What is weak? We always tell the people, if that hadith is weak, we are weaker than it. Because normally the hadith which we apply, if you want to say weak, it means the narrator is maybe unknown, or maybe it came in different form of words. And but the content, the material, or the matin, they call it matin, the content of the hadith, it's khair. It's khair. Now for that man here, the prohibition here, Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam stop people from eating while they're impure. Don't eat while you're impure. Why? Because remove the positive energy from your body and lead you to poverty. He said like that. If you have fornication, what you call the intercourse with your wife, then try to at least go and make wudu. Then you can eat. Then Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as you said last time, I'm continuing the other one, that you're not allowed to urinate or to relieve yourself under the fruitful tree, the fruit tree. You're not allowed. Or the middle of the road, you're not allowed. There is a lot of harm to you and harm of the other. Eating with the left hand is not prohibited. We don't say makruh. We didn't say not, it's not nice. I'm telling you, not allowed. You will be questioned about it. So, eating. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he was asking someone to eat with the right hand. And from small, you must teach your children, no, left hand no. Left hand no, because we need from ashabul yameen. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, stop women to follow the janazah. Never ever allow your wife or your daughter to drive like the non-Muslim and to follow, walk behind janazah. That is straight and clear. So your mom passed away, your father, your brother, so we have to teach the ladies, if you go there, you do harm the mayyit. You are not favoring him. It's not a sign of love. If you really love the mayyit, don't hurt him in the grave. Brother, sister in Islam, all of us, we're telling Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, sami'na wa ata'na. We have heard and we do obey you. We ask Allah, may Allah make you amongst those who said sami'na وأطعنا. Short break. We'll continue with it inshallah after short break. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome back, brothers and sisters in Islam. And once again, we say shukran that you're tuning to our program, and may Allah make it easy for you, inshallah, to practice what our Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked us to do, and to abstain and stay away from what he asked us not to do it. One of the prohibition or the command of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam for me and you to stop, that do not, as I said before the break, do not let the female to follow the funeral janaza. When we say janaza, it means you're carrying the mayyat, then the lady walk behind or drive behind. Not allowed, because the malaika curse you. Finish. I got someone here, said, no, you look naked or what? No. It's like that. That action is not accepted by Allah and His Rasul for so many reasons. Then, not allowed to burn something with fire, living being with fire. You catch a mosquito or you catch anything and you throw it on the fire, not allowed. My message, with my full love to our brothers who are living in a village next to the river, and you're catching fish, you're fishing, and the fish is still alive. I did see it here in South Africa and see it in some part of Africa. And we love our African people, we love them. And now I'm teaching you, and I'm telling you, wait for the fish to die. Don't put the fish life on the braai stand. Because some people live in the rural area or the village there on the next to the river. Catching the fish, put it on the fire immediately. Wallahi, is not allowed in Islam. Only because you're torturing the animal and you did burn the living creature of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So do not throw any living in the fire. Even if there's not a fish, anything, you're catching a rat or lizard or mosquito or fly, no. Right, next one, insulting the rooster. Many of us, we got chicken, or maybe next door got a chicken, or a little bit there, and at night they make adhan, this one, they call it adhan. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam prohibited us, don't put any comment. You must say la ilaha illallah. Is a muadhin. He saw the angel. It's a barakah for the one who listen. So do not shout that chicken or that rooster when it make adhan. La tasubbu ddik fa innahu yuqidhu lissalah. He waking you up for salah. So now we learn now that no comment. Keep quiet. Or don't buy the chicken. Give it to someone else. But this one, every day you're going to get irritated by his adhan. Now you disobey Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Another thing which I have to say to all our sisters and mother, do not keep the dustbin stay at night inside your house. The dustbin or that rubbish there you do, you don't keep it out of the house, because it is a maq'adu shayatan. The shayateen and jinn, they come for that thing. So you got some old stuff, and it takes also the positive energy from the house. That's why we have a fight. So sisters in Islam, when you sweep the house, clean the kitchen, you got food and all the dustbin here, please keep it outside. Our Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam said like that, right? Another thing which very, very important, and I don't know many sisters, they're going to send, call me and all that, but let me say it, then we can fight later on. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam prohibited any woman must not leave the house without permission of her husband. You take a general permission from your husband. Now your husband said, all right, do what you want. Yeah, halal, not haram, no problem. But to let your husband phone and say, where are you? No, that is not allowed. You must inform your husband before you leave the house. So, بغير إذن. Every angel curse her till she return back. And every creature of Allah cursing her till she come back. Stop harming yourself by leaving the house without a permission of your husband. If you are a working woman Oh, you are free woman, as the husband give you ijazah, this is something else. You have permission, general permission. But inform your husband, where are you? Because you'll be cursed till you come back. The ulama said, even from jinn and ins, you're gaining a lot of curse till you return home. Another thing also for women, and I have to say it, excuse me for that, I know many women like to beautify herself, put makeup, and that is good. Fatima radiallahu anha, she bought half of her mahar is a makeup and atar, but for her husband, not for outside. Now, I'm very sorry to say that our wives and our daughters, they're putting makeup for the outsider, not inside. You sit at home with a very, very abnormal clothes, and you don't look, take care of your body for your husband, but for wedding and for going out to the mall and outside, you can't make tazayyun to someone else is not your husband. Right. Then, al-qina, music. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said it and also did the action that he does not allow the people listen to the singer or the music, the instrument. Now I know many people, the people are going to talk about the music. We got something is called hearing, we got something is called listening. You're walking on a mall or in the street and you find someone play the music. Now you are hearing the music, you're just hearing it. Or you're on the taxi and you put that music on the bus. Our ears doesn't have a lead. But to buy the thing and you change the channel and you choose select and all that, now you are not hearing, now you are listening. So brother and sister in Islam, enough for us to hear, don't listen. So now you said, I'm hearing. What do you mean hearing? Like you walk, you don't know what that man's singing about. You don't know the topic of the song, what he's talking about. Singer and song. Nabi Muhammad put his two fingers right inside the ears. If you trust me, trust Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and say, no, I won't listen because it's not allowed. It's not allowed. Then they say, no, it's an Islamic song. I know. It's an Islamic song. No, it's a very lovely music. And our Nabi said, no. I don't know what you're going to do now. As he told you, no for many things. Why for this one you want to argue? Then, backbiting. Gossiping and backbiting is our biggest problem. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his ayah. Is the Quran and the Sunnah prohibited us. وَلَا يَغْتَبْ بَعْضُكُمْ بَعْضًا. Gossiping and backbiting, it's you're eating the flesh of your Muslim brother alive and dead. So now here, لَا يَدْخُلَ الْجَنَّةَ قَتَّعَتْ. No backbiter will enter Jannah. You are not relieving yourself, you are not just talking and killing time, you are committing a sin. So, the asami'u mughtab, the listener of backbiting is also backbiter. Unfortunately, we got some visitor come to us, or we go to the people, then we talk general, we talk about politics, sports, any general talk, then shaitan doesn't allow us to carry on with that. He bring us to ghaibat and backbiting. If we can be aware about that and we close that subject, that lady or that man will never continue. Because when you say, no, Allahumma ghafir lana wa lahum, we don't want to backbite people. Just change the topic. Just let's talk about something else. Allah, we can't wash his sin. Because once you speak bad about someone, you are donating all your good deeds to him and you're receiving his sin. So actually we are not harming him, we are benefiting him and we lose ourselves. So love yourself and stop backbiting. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam stop us like that. Then talking about alcohol, Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when we talk about khamar, I don't know the name of that drinks or all that, but I'm telling you, if the milk cause intoxication, it's also khamar, plain milk or the bread. So khamar mentioned in Quran in the hadith of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, mudminu khamrin ka'abidu wathan. If you are addicted to drinking alcoholic, you are equal to the idol worshipper. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save you from all that, inshallah. Short break, we'll continue after the break. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome back, brother and sister in Islam. And once again, we say shukran jazilan that you are watching our program. Shukran jazilan to all our viewers in Cape Town and Durban and here on Pretoria and in that beautiful city, Lodium, and my hometown, Linasia, and each and every part of South Africa. Shukran jazilan that you're always watching our ITV, my cameraman, my sound engineer, and our editors and our studio manager and everyone here. We greet you and we say shukran jazeera. May Allah make it easy for us, inshallah, to practice Deen al-Islam. I'm just responding to the request of our viewers for the prohibition of the thing. It's called manhi anhu, the prohibited. And let me remind you that Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is a Nabi. So he does not talk from his own. His inspiration, wahi, Jibreel alayhi salam. So he got full right and Allah give him authority and permission to make tahleel and tahreem. So it's him. So it's not his own desire. It is a command of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Then before the break, I was talking about alcohol. I don't know, some people, they don't count drugs and cocaine and all the other drugs as an alcoholic. They think only about the liquid like wine and champagne and the other thing there. Brother and sister in Islam, khamr, there's no specific name for it. Anything, because khamr was a grape before. It was inab. The dates can be khamr also. You can try to process it and you make khamr. Bread. So don't try to find a name for it. Anything. Because Allah will curse ghariswa, the one who planted. You plant the grape for that reason. Then wa'asiruha, the one who juice it, the one who manufactures it. Washaribuha, the one who drinks it. Wasaqiha, the one who, the waitress, the one who pour it for them. Wabai'uha, the one who sell it. Wamushtariha, you buy it for someone else. Like some Muslims say, I'm buying it to give it a present to someone else. No. Wa'akilu thamanaha, the one who consumed the price of it. Right? Wahamiluha, the one who transported to carry it. Right? Wal mahmula ilayhi, and the one who been carried for him, also curse. And his salah is not accepted. All these people here, and his not salat accepted for 40 days. So stay away from khamar. Don't even witness that one. Sometimes we go to the shopping or the mall or the place and we find the khamar there, we walk away. We don't pass even, because the curse of Allah will come to you. That is our deen. It's not because we it's our own personal choice. It is the deen of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Then after Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I know that so many ayat regarding the riba, but riba interest is not allowed. Is a major sin in Islam. So the one who wrote it, the one who witnessed it, the one who deal with it, and the one who eat from it, that also cursed and will be punished on the day of Qiyamah. Next one, false witness. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was warning you and I that no way to have a false witness. Suppressing the witness is a crime. That فَإِنَّهُ آثِمٌ قَلْبَهُ, his heart deserved the punishment. Athim is a sinner. Right. Shahada, the witness. Our shahada is La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That's called shahada, witness, testimony. La ilaha illallah is the Quran. Muhammadur Rasulullah is a sunnah. So when you deny the Quran and you deny the sunnah, you did give a false witness. Committing sin is also false witness. Why? Because adultery is haram. And you did witness and accept that it is haram. When you commit it, you change your witness. You say, no, it's not haram, or it's okay. So that is called the dangerous false witness. Then, when you deny the sunnah, you believe in Rasulullah, you must accept the sunnah. He said, no, all right, that is also false witness. Then we got someone who doesn't want to utter the witness. Many of the mothers or the neighbors or the uncle or grandmother, they heard the will of the mayyit. Her husband said, when I die, you must do this, this, this. And the lady said, no, I didn't hear that. She hide and suppress the witness. And some people are scared of problem and they say, no, take me out of that story. I can't give the witness. You have to give the witness because you will be punished. Katmush ala wa qawlu zur. I'm not talking about the one who give the false witness. I'm talking about the one who hold, doesn't want to utter the false witness, the witness itself. So us, if someone asks us about halal and haram, so katmul ilm, you suppress the knowledge, so you involve on the false witness or you suppress the witness of Allah tabarakata. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prohibited you and I and every Muslim to beat any living being on his face. Cow, chicken, dog, human being, the face is the noblest part of your body. There's nothing, it's called hitting on at all. We don't actually torturing people and beat people. So hitting the face is not allowed in Islam at all. I know you're angry, you want to discipline your child. No way to touch the face of the person. That message for those who teaching, those who teach Quran and all that, and the greatest ni'mah you give it to your child when you hand him to a salih hafiz or muallim who can let your son love the Quran, not hate the Quran. Because some people cause us to hate the Quran because of his method or his ugly way of presenting the kitab of Allah. And unfortunately, alhamdulillah, they are not so much, few. They, when you want to sell a shoes, you put it in a lovely display window and you put a little bit of flowers around it, shoes, you're going to use it on the floor. And when you want to present the deen of Allah, you put it in an ugly way. So the people hate that the goods of Allah or the hadiyat of Allah, no. My message to myself and everyone who present deen of Islam, you have to display it in a beautiful window. You can't put the shoes on the window and then you present deen in an ugly way by calling yourself a pious. We call it a fake piety. That is a very false piety. If you really love Allah and His Rasul, you must present and introduce His deen in a beautiful way to encourage the people to accept the work of Allah or the deen of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Then Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prohibited me and you and the man to look at the private part of a man. That message for those who are on the internet, on YouTube, those who are dealing with the haram stuff. Brother and sister in Islam, awrah is not only the private part for the man from the navel till the knees. So that, so you ask your children when they play soccer, you must put a nice trouser, cover the awrah. When you are in the swimming pool, when they are in the school, we know the children, they got that thing. So be careful, teach your children that you must cover. I know your son passing like that, his sister or his brother or his father, say, my friend, you come out from the bathroom, mind your awrah because two of you are cursed by Allah. Two, the one who see. I'm not talking about the video on the YouTube and all this musibah day. I'm talking about our home. And women should not look at the aura of another woman. That is a warning and advice for those who go to gym or to beauty center or the massage places and all that. Non-Muslim women, we treat her like he. Again, I'm repeating, the non-Muslim woman is not normal like the Muslim man. She got a certain restriction for your body. Right. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam forbid us to read salah on the place which salah is not accepted. So mind the place you read salah. I know you're traveling and you're going for holiday, picnic, watch out. Number one, in a grave. You can't read salah on a graveyard at all. Right. On the middle of the road. Right in the center of the road like that, you're not allowed. It actually is not accepted. Right. The cage of the camel, where the camel park, you're not allowed. On top of the Kaaba, you're not allowed. And the ulama said the to read Salah on the dasman, dumping place, where the place is a dumping. So that is called the Nahi of Nabi Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And you ask your nearer Imam or one man who knows, and you go and ask, you will find the prohibition or the manhi anhu, not in Quran, in the hadith of Nabi Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And it actually is touching our life, this one. We ask Rabbul Alameen, may Allah save you from any prohibited thing which caused the anger of Allah or the punishment on the day of Qiyamah. Short break, we'll continue after the break. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome back, brother and sister in Islam. And once again, we say shukran jazilan. We ask Rabbul Izzat tabarak wa ta'ala, may Allah soften your heart and my heart to accept the rules of Allah and the command of Allah and the command of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, may Allah Rabbul Izzat tabarak wa ta'ala soften the heart of our children to accept the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and to stay away from any act can cause a problem in our life and cause the azab and punishment in the day of Qiyamah. Brother and sister in Islam, it sounds a small thing. Because on the break we are thinking, just to remind you that why you think you people call it small haram. But don't talk about the size of the sin. Talk about the punishment. That sometimes you don't answer the your daddy's call. And you think it's a small haram. But no, it's a small act, but it's a big haram. Because Allah tabarak wa ta'ala will punish you and become part of uququl walidain. A woman enter Jahannam because she look up the cat and the cat dies. Never kill the cat directly. So now, what is a cat? No, it's nothing to do with the cat. It's about the command of Allah and the act and the punishment of Allah. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke about those alladhina ya'maluna as-su'a bijahala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala discussed that some people like you and I committing sin with unawareness. We become unaware. So what is jahil? Ignorance or jahala? You're unaware. We didn't discuss it. Right. Jahala, su is a sin. Right. Bijahala, you're unaware that the sin is sin, or unaware the outcome of that sin or the punishment of that sin. For example, you mommy, you don't know the ayat of Quran discussing the seriousness of relationship between you and mom, your mother, or your dad. And then many of our children, or us, we deal with our parents as like our brothers and aunties and a classmate. Is your mother. Sometimes the mother nowadays, they are very young mother or uneducated mother. She is unaware that this child, when he raises his voice, is committing a major sin. No, I will give maaf to my son. Yeah, but that's called your right. What about the right of Sharia? He will never be free of the court of God. You know, in our normal life here, they say, all right, that is the right of the victim. But where is the right of the state? Your right of the state, of the country. So now they say, okay, you're free from that problem, but come, we'll catch you because you overspeed on the highway. Never mind you knock that man or not. So now, sometimes the parents of the children don't know the seriousness of the sin or the seriousness of the punishment of the sin. That one we have to teach our children. You think is a smaller, but look at the punishment. When we talk today, we say mal'oon, cursed. Cursed, it means out of the mercy of Allah. And who cursed him? Not me and you. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and Allah and Malaika. So who else can stand up and fix that problem if Allah doesn't want that person in the day of Qiyamah? Which power higher than Allah to cancel that decision of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala or rectify Allah's decision? That's why we said to the brother, your sin either you are jahil to you don't know is it haram or halal or big haram, or maybe you don't know that was the outcome or the result of it on the day of Qiyamah. So one of this one here, it's al-halfu bighayrillah, to take an oath or qasam besides the name of Allah. Many of our friends in all language, they say qasam, wal Quran, by the grave of my father, I can lose my son, I swear by my life. You know, you people take an oath with something besides Allah. We know that our oath and our qasam is not for anything. You can't say wallahi, wallahi for anything. If you are in a court, if you want to free, or you are a witness, or you want to free yourself from the charge, you just want to prove that you speak the truth. But sometimes wallahi is a genuine, wallahi is a cost price, that is bayal halaf, is cursed. Allah will never look at him with the eyes of mercy on the day of Qiyamah. Wallahi is a cost price. Wallahi, I was there by the door. So you got three forms of qasam. You got wallahi, billahi, tallahi. There's nothing more than that. If you made qasam with anything besides these three words, wallahi, billahi, tallahi, you must say la ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah, you renew your iman, because you're going to fall on some thought of shirk. So try to hold your tongue, don't make qasam, especially the qasam about the past. It's a very dangerous one, the yameen or the qasam about the past. Then al-half bighayrillah, you can't make a qasam by the grave of your father, or I can die tomorrow, all that type of, you must, falaysa min Allahi fi shay, Allah has nothing to do with him besides punishment on a day of Qiyam. Then another thing, Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prohibited Muslim, while the Imam climbed the mimbar Friday to give the Jum'ah talk, stop talking. Why? Because that is called lagha. Lagha, wa man lagha fala jum'ata lah. Anyone who cancels his Jum'ah, you lost the Jum'ah for you and for the one who was talking to you. And whosoever said to his brother, sit, it means shh, keep quiet. Unfortunately, we see in some of our mosques, the people are talking in the Arabic khutbah. No, that Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam forbid people and prohibited people do not talk in the while the Imam give, it's because this Arabic khutbah is equal to two rak'at. So it's like you are in salah. So you just sit and listen to that one. Then I got one here, I think the children also the involved on it, say stop drinking kalbaha'im. Stop drinking like the animal. What is the animal? You just swallow the water. You take the glass or the cup and you just pour it like this. No, we suck the water. We are not, we suck it, we don't drink it like that, because it will cause a problem. Now here, they said, cause a problem, you don't know, it's a health problem and problem on the stomach and colon, a lot of scientific miracle on that sunnah on Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Fasharib is the people of Jahannam, you're going to drink like that. And animal on the desert, they drink like that, then they swallow stones and nails and some other part, the other thing which cause a problem on the stomach. Plus, there's no barakah. You must drink on the three times, three sips, and you breathe on it and you drink, and you breathe and you get it again. Then a beautiful, beautiful sunnah of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that do not employ or use any worker without telling him the wages. I'm telling you, you jump on the taxi, you say how much, because you're going to cause a problem there when you arrive in your destination. You call the plumber, call the one who cut your garden, or the one who clean, you say, inshallah, we'll talk, I'll look after you. You must name the wages, you must specify the wages. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, it's like that. You have to tell him, I'm going to pay you so much. If he's happy, happy. If he's not happy, khalas. But to use that person and he's waking and sweating. No, that is not allowed in Islam. Then give him his wages before his sweat gets dry. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam encouraging me and you to give him his wages payment while he's still sweating. Why? To appreciate. Because if you just work whole day and no payment, how are you going to go home? I know you're going to pay him later, but it's better to give him cash while the sweat is, so that he can forget that tiredness and that hardship he had. If he got money, he will forget his pain. He will forget his pain and that his struggle. And it's better to give him قَبْلَ أَن يَجُفَّ عَرَقَ before his sweat get dry. Our Nabi said like that. Brothers and sisters in Islam, we ask Rabbul Izzat Tabarak wa Ta'ala, may Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala make it easy for us to obey Allah and His Rasul. Now, for my elderly people, we love you for the sake of Allah. Make dua that Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala grant you husnul khatim, a happy end. Love everyone, worship Allah, don't die with bid'ah and innovation. Don't invent on Deen al-Islam, just practice Quran and Sunnah. Love everybody, try to forgive everybody. Then you close your eyes. فَلَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. We ask Rabbul Izzat Tabarak wa Ta'ala, may Allah make it easy and forgive our parents and forgive us for any shortcoming we have done against our parents, inshallah. رَبَّنَا إِنَّنَا سَمِعْنَا مُنَادِيًا يُنَادِي لِلْإِيمَانِ أَنْ آمِنُوا بِرَبِّكُمْ فَآمَنَّا. ربنا فاغفر لنا ذنوبنا وكفر عنا سيئاتنا وتوفنا مع الأبرار. Till we see you inshallah next time. شكرا جزيلا. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.